Say again, Buzz, you were cut out there.
Okay, I'll see you at 71 hours.
Yeah, roger.
This is Apollo Control. So much for that. Looks like they're going to turn over and go back to sleep. At 69 hours, 19 minutes ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Thank you. We'll be right back. Sir.
Planned wake-up time for the crew is 71 hours elapsed. Cliff Charlesworth and the green team of flight controllers has just relieved Glenn Lenny's black team. Capcom now is Bruce McCandless. Apollo 11 is 13,638 nautical miles from the moon. Velocity 4,047 feet per second, lunar referenced. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Apollo 11 is 12,486 nautical miles from the moon, approaching at a velocity of 4,087 feet per second. We'll stand by here and see whether we put in a call to the crew. We're putting a call into the crew now.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Good morning again, Houston, Apollo 11.
Roger, 11, good morning.
Would you like the O2 purge this morning?
Yes, indeed, O2 fuel cell purge at 71 hours, and when you feel like copying, I've got a flight plan update containing, I guess, that and some other items for you.
Okay, stand by. Apollo 11. Go ahead with the flight plan update.
Roger 11, this is Houston. At approximately 71 hours to 72 hours, we have you down for an EAT period, which I imagine is probably in progress already. 71 hours O2 fuel cell purge, 72 hours GET, a CO2 filter change number 6, secondary radiator flow check, and we'll send you up a P-37 block data on 2-hour fast paracentian fast return mode abort. At 73 hours, 00 minutes, stop PTC at approximately 0 degrees roll. That is, when you're coming up on 0 degrees roll angle, around 73 hours, we'd like you to stop PTC. And perform a P-52 option 3, remaining in the PTC reps met, for a drift check. 73 hours, 20 minutes. We'll give you a P-27 update to the landing site reps met, LOI-1 state vector and target load. 73 hours, 30 minutes. The maneuver to 000 roll pitch and yaw. High gain antenna angles will be pitch 0, yaw 335, and perform a P-52 option 1 using the new landing site rest mat. Resume the nominal flight plan at 74 hours GET. Over.
Okay, we'll get started on fuel cell purge while we're eating. CO2 canister change number 6. Secondary radiator flow check. Stop pads also 72 hours. Stop PTC, 0 roll at 73. Do a P-52 option 3. We'll get your uplinked rest mat to the landing site. And, 0003. Now, is this with the old rest mat or the new rest mat?
This is with the
antenna and pitch.
This is with the new rest mat, Buzz. 7, this is Houston, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Houston, go ahead.
Roger, 11, correction on my last. At 7320, we uplinked you the new reps, Matt. And 7330, we'd like you to maneuver to zero roll, zero pitch, zero yaw in the old reps, Matt. And then torque around to the new reps, Matt. And run your P-52 option 1 in that same inertial attitude, over.
Roger, understand.
And I got a consumables update when you're ready to copy.
I just got up, but you didn't catch me on that one.
Okay, I have one for you.
Okay, we're ready to copy that consumable update.
Roger. As of GET 6800, RCS total minus 4.5%, corresponding to approximately minus 5.3 pounds. Alpha, minus 6.0%, minus 1.0%, minus 7.0%, minus 3.0%, H2 total minus 1.2 pounds, O2 total plus 10 pounds, over.
Roger, and our readouts on board are Alpha is 82, Bravo is 84, Coco is 84, and Delta is 87.
Houston, Roger out.
And you want us to cycle AO2 and H2 bands, I'm asking them.
Eleven, this is Houston. Affirmative, over.
Okay.
Thank you.
Apollo 11. I have a status report for you.
Go ahead, 11.
Roger, on fleet. CDR, CMP 7.5, LMP 6.5. Over.
Roger, 7.5 for each. Over.
Negative, LMP 6.5.
Roger, 7.5, 7.5, and 6.5. And I got a few words for you here on the SPS engine performance. Over.
Okay, we're ready, let's.
Okay, 11, it turns out that the engine performance during both of your burns so far this mission has been the same as it was on engine acceptance tests. The onboard PC reading is due to a known gauge calibration factor between what they've actually got in the chamber and what you're reading out on the gauge. We expect single bank operation to be 90, that is 9 or 0 PSI on the gauge, with an actual chamber pressure of 9 or 5 PSI. In dual bank operation, the chamber pressure is 9.4 PSI on the gauge, with an actual of 9 or 9 PSI. 8.0 PSI on the gauge on board correlates to 8.3 PSI actual, and we recommend that you stick to an LOI termination cue of 8.0 PSI on the gauge. That is no change to the mission rules. Over.
Apollo 11, Roger. We got all that.
Houston out.
This is Apollo Control at 71 hours, 31 minutes. Apollo 11's distance from the moon now 11,232 nautical miles, approaching at a velocity of 4,141 feet per second.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Go ahead, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Go ahead, over.
Houston, you read Apollo 11.
Roger, 11, we're reading you loud and clear now. We were down in the noise as we switched antennas a minute or so ago, over.
Roger, what sort of settings could you recommend for that solar corona? We've got the sun right behind the edge of the moon now.
Roger.
Quite an eerie sight. There's a very marked three-dimensional aspect of having the sun's corona coming from behind the moon the way it is.
Roger.
Looks as though, I guess what's given it that three-dimensional effect is the Earth shine. I can see Tycho fairly clearly, at least if I'm right side up, I believe that's Tycho, in moon shine. I mean, in Earth shine. And of course, I can see the sky is lit all the way around the moon, even on the limb of it where there's no earth shine or sunshine.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, if you'd like to take some pictures, we recommend using magazine Uniform, which is loaded with high-speed black and white film, interior lights off, electric Hasselblad with the 80-millimeter lens, and you're going to have to hand-hold this, I guess. We're recommending an f-stop of 2.8, and we'd like to get a sequence of time exposures. Over.
Okay. Okay, you want the magazine uniform instead of magazine Tango?
Roger, we're not trying to get you all wrapped up in a procedure here. This is on a not-to-interfere basis. Of course, over.
Okay.
And on the exposures, we're looking for an eighth of a second, a half a second, and if you think you can steady the camera against anything to get longer exposures, 2 seconds, 4 seconds, and 8 seconds, over.
Roger, copy.
Roger up. Apollo 11, Houston, over.
Roger, Houston.
Roger, we'd like to do a little cryo tank balancing. So if you could position the oxygen tank number one heater switched off and hydrogen tank two heater switched off, leaving all the rest of the cryo switches the same, we'll let it run that way for a few hours, over.
Okay, stand by,
one of
those switches, we'll get
them
in a minute.
Roger. And how far out can you see the corona extending? Over.
Thank you.
11, this is Houston. I think we have comm again. We heard you calling, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Were you calling, over?
Apollo 11, I understand you want the heaters off for hydrogen tank 1 and oxygen tank 1. Is that affirmative?
That's negative, Mike. Hydrogen tank number 2 heaters off and oxygen tank number 1 heaters off.
Okay.
Roger out.
Yeah, I have hydrogen tank number 2 heaters off. I have oxygen tank number 1 heaters off.
Roger out.
sunshine coming through the window is so bright you can read a book by it.
Oh, very good.
That was Mike Collins reporting.
Along the ecliptic line, we can see Corona light out to 2 lunar diameters from this location. The bright light only extends out about an eighth to a quarter of the lunar radius.
Roger, I understand that you can see the corona approximately 200 solar diameters out along the ecliptic, and the bright light extends out approximately 1/8 to 1/4 lunar radius, over.
That's 2 lunar diameters along the ecliptic, and the bright part, right, a quarter to an eighth of a lunar radius out. And that's perpendicular to the ecliptic line on the South Pole.
Roger.
That last transmission was from Neil Armstrong.
Houston, it's been a real change for us. Now we're able to see stars again and recognize constellations for the first time on the trip. It's the sky is full of stars, just like the night side of Earth. But all the way here, we've only been able to see stars occasionally and perhaps through the monocular, but not recognize any star patterns.
I guess it's turned into night up there, really, hasn't it?